You know what? It was just an article of clothing, and I'll get into that a little bit more in just a moment here. But we do have new information also on the PPO involving Bianca's father, DeAndre Lane, and his ex-wife. And again, like you said, Diane and Joanne, a lot of people, hundreds of volunteers, turned out today with one goal in mind, finding Bianca.
And Lord knows what I would do if something like that happened to my baby.
On this fifth day of searching for two-year-old Bianca, volunteer searchers found pink clothing in a vacant flat near John R. and Custer. They found the items after removing a piece of wood that had been propped up against a basement opening.
Me and the other lady, we decided to go look in there in the crack, and when we looked in the crack, we found the pink shirt-like dress.
Detroit police have said that they questioned DeAndre Lane's story about an armed carjacker driving away with his little girl inside. And while they have not named him as a suspect, they say they have also not ruled him out. And today we are learning more about the personal protection order case that landed Lane in jail the day he reported his daughter kidnapped. The outstanding arrest warrant stemmed from Lane failing to appear in court on the PPO involving his ex-wife. They were only married a short time and they have a child together. But at one point earlier this year, she wrote in the PPO request that Lane sent her text messages that seemed threatening. But the most important thing right now for local, state, and federal agencies, and even hundreds of strangers, is searching for Bianca and finding out what may have happened to her.
If he has done any wrong, he will suffer the consequences and he will have to handle that. We don't have to worry about that. That's in God's hands. We're more concerned with the two-year-old who can't feed herself and can't take care of herself. That's our main focus, and that's always going to be our focus.
Anyone that might know anything, the smallest detail, just don't be afraid to step up, speak up, say something, bring my daughter home, please.
And we're back here live outside the Detroit Police Department Central Station, located on East Grand Boulevard and Woodward here. And this is exactly where investigators who are working on this case are actually huddled in and working out of. This is kind of like their home base here. And then they fan out from here once they all get their marching orders. I did just speak to an FBI spokesperson who says the clothing that was found earlier by volunteer searchers does not appear to be related to this case. So the search continues. Reporting live in Detroit, Kimberly Craig, 7 Action News. Back to you.
And Kim, speaking of the search, we mentioned so many people have come out to try to find that little girl. Are they planning the volunteers on being out again tomorrow?
Absolutely. They will be volunteering again, and they're working in with police, some community volunteer officers that are with the police department. Those police officers are going out again in small groups, starting again at 10:30 tomorrow morning. So anybody who wants to volunteer can show up at the Metropolitan Church, Metropolitan Methodist Church on Woodward. I think the address is 8000 Woodward Avenue. They can show up there at 10:30 tomorrow morning. They had over 200 volunteers today, about 160 yesterday. And Joanne, I'm telling you, people are coming individually, they're coming in their church groups, they're coming in their neighborhood groups, or just a group of friends coming out in hopes of finding Bianca.
The story has touched so many people, and
yes,
you just feel like that's what you could do to
yes.
help. So, Kim, thanks so much for the report.